I'm not too much. Now, it's getting exciting all week because we've been talking about what the Lord laid in my heart from Jude chapter 1. Of course, Jude is just one chapter. Verse 20 and 21. And then he says, but you be not building up yourselves on your most holy faith. And then he says, how? By praying in the Holy Ghost. Now, yesterday I was explaining to you that you can be speaking in tongues and yet not praying in the Holy Ghost. See, when you're praying in the Holy Ghost, you know. Now that's the amazing thing. You will know when these things is operating in your life. So don't think it's just something that works. You don't understand how it works. You just they say, yeah, there are people who are trying to get someone filled with the Holy Ghost, and they go, say after me, Raboskia, come on, run away from such people. They are not giving the right thing. No. But all you need is for the Holy Ghost to reside in you. And let me tell you this truth. The day you got born again, that day the Holy Ghost came to reside in you. So it's not like, now I'm born again, the next thing now I need to receive the Holy Ghost. How did you get born again without the Holy Ghost? Praise God. So now that you are saved, and this is one of the signs that should follow you. And what is it? New tongues. So praying in the Holy Ghost definitely will cause you to speak new tongues. Are you getting what I'm saying? Now, listen. You can also be praying in the Holy Ghost and you are speaking English or a language you understand. So, really? Oh, yes. And how can that be new tongues? Oh, sure. When you in the place of prayer, you just notice that new vocabularies are coming to you. You get what I'm saying? I mean, you're praying and some strange things begin to come, you know, to your spirit. Some strange words with boldness are just coming to your spirit. It can be in English or in the language you understand. But you know that this is new. You know what I'm talking about? You just prophesying, and you know, I mean, oh, listen, if you don't experience this, you will never know what I'm talking about until you experience it. So how do I experience it? Get yourself into the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Just get yourself to that place of prayer. Say, Holy Spirit, what Pastor George is talking about? I want it. You know, I remember one day we had a little meeting. Yeah. And I asked all of them, I said, how many of you are born again here? And they all raised up their hand. I said, okay, how many of you have the Holy Ghost and you speak in tongues? And one person said, he didn't speak in tongues. I said, well, how long have you been born again? And then he said, how do you prove you're born again? Jesus said, God is a spirit, and those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And you've been worshiping God. So how have you been worshiping God? So how do you worship God in spirit without the Holy Ghost? And then when I was done with him, he said, oh, what do I do? I said, I'm not going to pray for you. You go back to the Lord. And that's what I do most of the time. You go back to the Lord and say, Lord, I want it. And it will just come free. Praise God. And he called me back. He said, look, when I went, I just began to speak in tongues. I didn't know how it was happening. And then suddenly I began to sing in tongues. You know, it was so, so joyful. Listen, until you experience it, you will not understand it. Praise God. But those of you that have been experiencing this thing, it's time to take it to another level. How? Building up yourself in this. So he said, you can build up yourself. And you are doing that on your most, you know why I call it most holy faith? Because that's the purest kind of faith. Now, what do I mean faith? Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing what? The word of God, or hearing what? The voice of God. Now, I yield myself to the Holy Spirit, and he's giving me utterance to speak, and I'm just there speaking, and new tongues are coming to me. And while I'm speaking, maybe unknown tongue or maybe known tongue, see, while I'm speaking that, new vocabularies are coming. Things are happening. I'm just speaking Labusike, and suddenly just comes into my spirit. And words come, you know, I'm the healed of God. Now, you may never have said that before, but now it comes with so much of maybe you're sick in your body. And while you're doing that, remember it says building up yourself. So I'm just doing that in that weakness of my body, and I'm just doing that. Suddenly, you know, it just comes into my spirit like a rush. I am healed. Now, when that comes, do you know that is new tongue? Now, you know that that's not something you normally say. You know what I'm talking about? Now, when it comes like that, what do you do? Say, yes, I'm healed. Now, what happened? You've just added some block into your life. Say, building up. You know, see, building up yourself. So, you just added some stones, you know, into your life. Now, you're rising up like an edifice. That's what the Amplifier say. Rising up like an edifice. So, you're just putting, as you declare, say, yes, I'm healed. You know what will happen? Suddenly, you begin to see how healed you are. Suddenly, you begin to see how sickness cannot hold you down. You begin to see. Listen. It's not God coming down from heaven and saying, my son, let me pray for you. No, it's the Holy Ghost stirring up something from the inside of you. And it just busts out your whole skin. Remember the Bible says, if the spirit of him that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, what will he do? He will vitalize what? Your mortal body. Now, this is how it works. As you build yourself praying in the Holy Ghost, speaking in new tongues, what happens? Words will begin to come into your spirit. Words will begin to come into your mind. Now, what do you do with those words? Receive them. I receive it in the name of Jesus. Praise God. And what happens? It begins to manifest in your body. It begins to manifest all around you. Hallelujah. You've got to do this even right now because I've got to stop here now. Praise God. Listen, I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.